to shift you to your next level. Sometimes you gotta realize, you have to realize, oh, the batteries in your mic is going out on me. You have to realize that when God is ready to move you, He'll make you wonder what He's doing. Amen. Amen. He was comfortable in that job. And the Lord said, I'm about to shift something, something for her. So I got to get her out of her comfort zone. Amen. Amen. And I'm excited about not only God shifting me, but I'm excited about a new business venture coming your way. Hallelujah. God opening some doors. Oh, y'all think God. I'm crazy.
Yes, God.
And I know she says, well, Pastor, I don't know what you mean the new business venture. This is what the Lord is working on. So you just prepare yourself to make your own amount of money. Amen. You gotta accept what other folk will give you because other people are not your source. I'm really glad to say that God is my source. It ain't my job, it ain't my fiance, if my woman ain't my man. God is my source. If my man leave, God don't keep me.
Say so.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Yes, sir.
My mama don't want to do nothing for me no more. Yes, don't you worry about it. The Lord going to take care of me.
Come on.
If my friends turn their back on me,
and
just decide they don't like me no more, I'm glad I got somebody to talk to. Well, thank you, Jesus. I need somebody to touch their neighbor and repeat this song and say, no. I'm never alone.
Jesus.
How many of you glad you got Jesus? When your friends turned around and walked away from you, I was able to say, Lord, take care of me. And I learned that once you become a product of His, He'll take care of you. You may not have money in your pocket, but that don't mean God ain't gonna take care of you. You may not have friends anywhere, but God will take care of you. I'm a living witness. I wonder if I have any living witnesses. And it was days that you didn't know how you were gonna make it. There was a day that you cried until you couldn't cry no more. You was all cried out. But God brought you through. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I thank God for carrying me and bringing me thus far. He's a faithful God. He is faithful in all of His doings. And sometimes when we don't understand, only mean God is working.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
God ain't gonna do things that you understand all the time.
Amen.
His ways are not your ways, and His thoughts are not your thoughts. And what God said is, He said, I know the thoughts that I have for you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. God said, I know the thoughts that I have for you. They are good, and they are going to bring you to expect it in. God got an expected end for you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So I wanted to say thank God for that testimony.
Amen.
Because it encouraged a lot of people that were in here today.
Yes.
Some of y'all hear a word from the Lord that'll help you, or you won't even tell the people that you encouraged me. You won't even tell God's people that you encouraged me. What happened when you said about your job today, Elder Sandlin leaned over and he said, Pastor, I got a testimony too. The Lord, bless me with a job.
Come on, all right.
Testimony online. Sister Melita testified about some interviews and things happening for her. Amen. From last week to this week. Glory to God. Glory to God. From Sunday to Sunday. You don't know what God will do by next Sunday. Oh, I got to encourage your spirit. You don't I need somebody to say it in their spirit. 7 days. Pay all your bills in 7 days. He'll pull you out of debt in 7 days. He'll heal your body in 7 days. He'll bring your child home in 7 days. Seven days. What's the matter with your little problem? I need somebody to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you ain't even got a problem. God will take care of you. This for somebody with faith. This only for somebody with faith. Look at your neighbor and say, you'll do it in 7 days. Let y'all know you gotta watch praising the God, praising God on the word. Because when you learn how to praise God on the word like that, you will set the angel loose to work for you.
Thank you, Jesus.
And you know how to just praise God, the angels will say, God, we gotta do it for you. You can't let a praise like that in vain. Send me so I can go tell you.
At the right time.
In the right atmosphere.
Yeah. Thank you, God.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I don't know what you're talking, but I didn't do. I only came here to praise Him.
Yes, God.
I came to bathe in His Spirit.
Yes.
I came to let to feel the rain of His presence.
Yes.
So if you're looking for something else to happen, I'll tell you what I came here to do. Oh, hallelujah. I'm simply here to show my gratitude for what the Lord has been and done and who He is to me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because if He don't do nothing else,
come on.
If He stopped doing it right now, I'm still behind on my praise. So if you don't mind, let me just get a little bit, I gotta get caught up a little bit. Praising the Lord, and I don't mind even being behind on my praise, because that all that means is the more I praise Him, the much more He blesses me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Talking to every child. Talking to every child. Will you hear me, children? You hear me, babies? You better fall in love with me. You hear me? A.V.? You hear me? You better fall in love with it. You hear me, Tati? You better fall in love with it. Bernard, do you hear me? You better fall in love with it.